In this Photoshop tutorial, I'm going to show you how to put a person into a photo. So you want to visit the Eiffel Tower, but you can't get there. So what you do is take a photo in a different location and then transfer the person in there. And to get the images into Photoshop, just choose File, Open. There's a few steps. The first step we want to do is cut the person out. Let's do that now. And in Photoshop, we're going to move down and use the Object Selection tool. If you have an earlier version such as CS6, you're going to use Quick Selection. In our case, we're going to use Object Selection and choose Select Subject. Photoshop will automatically make the selection. To refine this edge, choose Select and Mask. Give it 1 pixel radius. And see how it's jaggy? Give it a little bit of feather and in contrast. It should mostly be smooth now, but grab the refine brush and just grab those last little bits to fix those. Turn on decontaminate colors. Output new layer with layer mask, click OK. Let's combine the images. With the layer selected, click and drag up into the tab of the image you want to go into. Don't release yet. Go into the image and now release, and there's our photo. Now we want to match the lighting. Notice on this photo, you can see the light comes from the top a little bit to the left. We need to flip our image. Control T for free transform. Right click. Choose flip horizontal. Now the lighting is coming from the same direction. You can tell because of the shadows under her arms and in her legs. It's still a little bit large. So what I'm going to do is hold down the Option key, scroll out so I can see these handles, and then we're just going to shrink this down a little bit and get the size where you want it. Now we need to match the color. With our layer still selected, choose Filter. Neural filters. Now, if you're using an older version of Photoshop, use match color. You'll see that under image adjustments, match color. But we're on the newer version, so we're using harmonization. Turn it on. Then choose a layer, and we want to choose the background. Photoshop will match the colors. Quite often it's too strong because of all the green in the grass, so take the strength down. And turn up the brightness just a little bit. There, that's better. Click OK. Now we need to put a shadow in so the person looks like they belong in this photograph. So with the layer selected, with the person, choose Effects, and we're going to select a drop shadow. When the drop shadow first appears, it's going to look like she's against a billboard. We want to put her into the environment. You can drag to change position. What we're looking for right now is the softness. Let's increase the size, which is the softness. In this case, 21 might be enough. Click OK. Now let's separate the shadow where it says effects. Right click and choose create layers. Notice it puts the shadow onto its own layer. Select the shadow layer, and we can see the lighting is coming down. So hit Control T or Command T for free transform. And let me drag it into position, because if the light's coming from the left, the shadow will go on the right and vice versa. Now I'm just going to drag this straight down because the sun's quite high. If the sun was coming at more of an angle, sunrise, sunset, you would choose right click and distort. and you would drag this out, in the opposite direction of the sun. In this case, there's not much of a shadow because the sun's quite high up, so we're just going to drag it down a little bit to the side, right-click, and choose skew. I'm just going to drag the back across a little bit. Hit enter. Reposition that shadow. Probably want to soften it a little bit. Filter, blur, and we're going to give it a Gaussian blur. Move it till it just softens. The last thing we need to do is reduce the opacity a little bit until it just kind of matches the scene. And see how the shadow just anchors the object into the photo. And if we look at this before, Eiffel Tower, and now you're there. So I hope you enjoyed this simple tutorial. I know it's not perfect, but I wanted to really focus just on the steps that you can use so you can add any person to any photograph. Let me know in the comments underneath if you found this helpful. And by the way, if you're new, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my weekly tutorials. And do me a favor, hit that like button, a thumbs up on YouTube. It helps us with the algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.